Let's talk now about the impact of reoffending. It's estimated that reoffenders in the criminal system cost over £18 billion every year. But those leaving the prison system are 70% less likely to reoffend if they end up in full-time work. Now, one person trying to give people a second chance is Steph Jones. He's set up a scheme to help ex-prisoners get experience and employment, and he's joined by one of his trainees, Trey. Trey, lovely to have you in chatting to us about this. Can you tell me a bit about, first of all, your story, like how you ended up offending and ended up in prison?
Pretty much. A few years back, I got arrested in possession of Class A. So I served about 14 months, luckily, because it was my first strike. And, it was my first ever time going to jail. So, yeah, it was a bit eye-opening, as you can imagine. And, it wasn't too bad, luckily for me. But, that's where...
What
woke up a bit.
What led you into crime? Was it the people you were hanging about with?
Yeah, people, the surroundings, the environment I grew up in, just not knowing who's really there for you, who's not. You know, just normal stuff everyone goes through.
Yeah, trusting the wrong people.
Yeah, yeah, and... trust, all sorts.
And then in prison.
Yeah.
What was that like? Were you thinking when you were in prison, I don't want to come back here again?
100%. It's just that the worst thing for me is it's how it affects people around you, like family and siblings and whatnot. That's what really hits you.
Yeah. So you didn't want to hurt your family anymore. And so what happened in prison that helped you then to get a job?
It's not so much what happened, it's just the reality of it.
Yeah.
When I was there, seeing how the system works and whatnot. Other people's situations as well, looking at the situation other people are in, it's all,
But you managed to get some kind of mentoring.
I got a mentor.
Yeah, tell us about that.
I met a mentor through an organisation called Switchback. Her name's Abby. Great person. She helped me out a lot. She approached me, I'd say, 8 weeks before my release. She'd come and see me every week, just have little meetings with me, one-to-ones. Talk to me about my future, what I want to do when I'm released and whatnot. And, through her, she introduced XO Bikes to me. Steph.
Yeah.
She proposed, an amazing opportunity for me, which was ideal for me as well.
And so, Steph, this is where you come into the picture. So tell me a bit about XO Bikes, then.
So XO Bikes is... the first social enterprise we've started. We're going to do 5 in 5 years. They're all started by a charity called Onwards and Upwards, which we founded, and the purpose of the charity is to break the cycle of reoffending.
Yeah.
And the thing that drives the cycle of reoffending that's trapping these guys is unemployment. You know, he's the reason I'm doing this. Prison's full of guys like this with tons of talent, there is ambition there, and they're smart businessmen. They're just dealing in the wrong product a lot of the time. But they can run rings around us. And when they come out, they don't want to go back. As Trey says, it's not a nice place to be in prison. And I started volunteering there about 4 years ago. And I just started seeing... And I was doing business mentoring for the guys. And then I'd see the odd guy would start to reappear. And I'm going, hold on, you looked me in the eye and said you weren't coming back. And the story emerged that, I couldn't get a job. And I thought, well, OK, if no-one's going to give him a job, I'm going to give him a job.
Yeah.
I thought, I haven't got a job to give them, so I need to start some businesses. We're not like a business with a purpose, we're a purpose with businesses.
Yeah.
He's the purpose. Our product, if you like, is a bloke that never goes back to prison. He just happens to make bikes. The next one will cut hair, the next one will do... Well, there's a whole bunch of business, so watch this space. But
And so, Trey, what was it like for you, getting that job?
It was great. Like I said, it was ideal for me. The timing was just perfect. Because bikes are already my passion from a young age. Like, fixing them, riding them, all I do is eat, sleep, ride, repeat. So when I saw this, I was just like, I need to do that, because it's just going to keep me on a straighter path.
And do you feel like that now? Do you feel like that, you're not going to go back to...
I'm comfortable,
And your family, because you mentioned them about the kind of hurt you put them through.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I bet they must be really proud
of
you now.
Over the moon. Over the moon. Just, yeah, everyone smiles, happy. Yeah. That's all you can ask for, isn't it?
And Steph, what's the reaction like? Because obviously, you know, ex-offenders get a bad rap for obvious reasons. What's the kind of reaction like from the people you're working with? And
incredible. That's the bit that. So there's two. There's three things we need to do. A, give them jobs ourselves and surround them in sort of confidence, trust them, respect them, and they fly. I mean, they are like these guys are like desert roses. I'm not exaggerating. They're sort of starved of so much in prison, and they come out. You give them a chance. You give them some belief. And you just give them the scope, and they just flourish. Yeah. He was a different guy 3 months ago, honestly. And we've got three guys now, and they're all just... One of the guys, Edu, he's not a bad mechanic, is he? He's no Trey. but when he was inside, his passion is numbers. So he started doing his accountancy exams. So when he came to us, he was level two, and he'd been away for about 15 years. Right? The guy had never been to the seaside. He went to the seaside for the first time last week. Saw his first beach, age 35. Anyway, so we said, look, come join us, do the course. We hired him on the back because he's a great bloke and he's not a bad mechanic. But we said, why don't you do our books under our sort of finance guy? He'll bring you on because hopefully he'll end up being our, you know, finance director.
And it's amazing that trust that you say, you know, you're giving them when there'll be lots of people out there who wouldn't do that.
Yeah, that's right. So what the reason we've set the businesses up is it's really a platform for these guys to show members of the public that read certain newspapers or whatever and have a certain impression of them. It's not true.
Yeah.
Right. And show business owners, because this is the big lever that needs to be moved. Business owners that you can build a business on these guys.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're great employees and you get loyalty, work ethic, integrity, trust. It's there in bucket loads.
Oh, amazing. Well, thank you so much for coming in for a chat about it and good luck with the other businesses as well. And Trey, good luck with everything too.
Yeah.
Still